Yeah, what do you want?
Yes. Have you come with questions?
Has there been any sign of the ship?
No, Mistress. Nor any word of our sister. We do not know where they travel now.
The freighter. It is important. And I thought the droid was as well, but I was wrong.
Mistress, we still do not know the significance of the ship or the droid. We downloaded all you asked, but we are still no closer to the answers you seek.
Then perhaps we will need to have faith that your sister will change her mind, remember her oath, and return to us with the answers we seek.
I hope so, Mistress. But there has been no word of her since she departed with the other four on the freighter.
Four?
Yes, Mistress. The Iridonian, the Ichani-trained pilot, the exile, and the old woman.
Old woman?
Yes, Mistress.
I do not recall seeing her.
Mistress, she was secured for much of the time the exile was here. At other times, you were meditating, and we did not wish to disturb you. Mistress, is there something wrong?
I am... tired. I sometimes feel as if things are collapsing all around us. It is just at the edge of perceptions, waiting. I fear things will collapse before our enemies reveal themselves.
Yes, Mistress.
I will meditate upon this. Perhaps it will clear my mind.
It might be helpful if I made some changes to my remote's maintenance laser to do spot repairs.
That would be a welcome improvement. My combat effectiveness could be better sustained, providing an advantageous arrangement. And my miniature counterpart would finally be able to pull his weight in a fight.
Back to the Hawk. There. You should be able to do some quick fixes. You won't be able to perform serious repairs, but you should be able to patch up any broken droids. You know, I think it's time I gave your cutting laser a little boost. It works fine for repairs, but we could use your help in a firefight. It. We'll make sure they keep you out of their scopes. Think of it this way. You can keep Goto in line with it. If you've got some time, I'd like to see what I can upgrade for you.
Yes, I do have a few moments to spare for your work. I would like to know what he is doing here, though.
He helps me out with repairs. That isn't a problem, is it?
I suppose not. Perhaps in working on my circuitry, your assistant will learn something about how a fully functional droid is constructed.
Just ignore him and let's get to work.
I would appreciate that. Our group has little in the way of time to spare, and I would not want to delay you from your other duties.
Right. Let's get you open. See what you can do. I have to say, you are put together quite well. There wasn't much to do.
As I told you, my design is streamlined and efficient, though I am pleased that you were able to make some improvements, and this was not just a waste of my valuable time.
There were a few things from my remote that I was able to integrate into your construction.
I see. Well, thank you. I'll let you get back to your work.
Message then. A man named Kavar wanted to get a hold of you urgently. He said that the Queen had arranged safe passage to Onderon for you, but I don't know how good their offer is anymore. He wouldn't tell me anything, just that he wanted to see you. He said it was urgent, but that doesn't matter now. This morning, General Vaklu met with the Council of Lords and declared that the Queen was guilty of treason. He'll be made regent if Talia and her royal guard are defeated. The military is divided on who to support. Civil war has fallen on Isis. I doubt that Queen Talia and her advisor will survive until nightfall. The balance of forces seem to favor Queen Talia. The royal palace is heavily fortified and defensible, and most of the soldiers are loyal to her. But Vaklu has new allies, Sith soldiers and their masters. The war has also driven the caged beasts in the streets mad. Braylor and I both concur. She doesn't stand a chance.
You underestimate the Force, Mandalorian. I sense that we may still get to Master Kavar in time. I sense there is something stirring on the moon itself. Tell me, have your senses picked up anything from Dxun?
Yes. Yes, we have. How? We picked up some transmissions from nearby in the jungle. We only have our shuttle sensors, so we know nothing more than that.
Those transmissions are the enemy. They are linked to the fate of Onderon. They must be stopped. Otherwise, the Mandalorian is right. Master Kavar and Queen Talia won't survive this day.
Dividing our forces at a time like this is foolhardy.
And this is why a common soldier will never triumph against a Jedi. Your military tactics are nothing compared to the Force.
It is essential and inevitable that we face both enemies at the same time. You must choose who will lead the expedition through the jungle to find our enemies and defeat them.
Serve as you wish.
You should send two others to go with the leader. Who else will accompany the expedition? Excellent choice. And who else? Good choice. Now, are you certain of your choices?
Mandalorian warriors will go with you to find the enemy camp. Just let me know when you want to head out. If you need supplies, talk with Kex. After you get into the jungle, you might not have another opportunity to stock up. Let me know if you want to go now. As you wish. Mandalore has arranged for special transportation to get to Isis.
Finally, we're close to our objective. I sent the rest of my men to secure the trail behind us. My troops will keep the path to the Mandalorian camp clear. Ahead lies the enemy. I can follow you a little bit further, but then I will set up command and control for my unit in the field. So, lead on.
Is mine. Serve.
Something you need.
Yeah?
My life is yours.
So lead on.
I sense we are getting farther from our destination.
Type 2 perimeter motion relay. That particular model has several security vulnerabilities and design flaws. Stealth field generators can fool them. If one of us could get close to it, I know the corporate override code for it. Amateurs shouldn't even bother building security technology.
So, you aren't completely ignorant in the ways of battle? Good. But all of you must pass through its perimeter, and undetected would be better.
Thank you.
the mines. If any of the ones close to the sensor are detonated, then we shouldn't even bother.
My life is yours.
Something.
Let's go.
Let's go.
How may I serve? Life is yours.
intruders! Kill them!
This is my first day on Dxun. My predecessor displeased our masters and was dealt with. The fool let Canox through the perimeter. The Sith don't tolerate any failure. I'm the fifth captain to command this base camp. The camp sits in the shadow of a tomb. My subordinates say that the body of an ancient warlord named Freedom Nerd lies inside. We don't know why we're here. We sit and make sure that no beasts come into our camp, and especially that they don't reach the tomb itself. A bleak assignment. Signing off. This jungle feels similar to Korriban before it fell after the war. Everyone is on edge. Executions for infractions are commonplace here. 50% more than my previous command. There's a bloodthirstiness to the jungle. The beasts here continually assault our mined perimeter. We had to replace the minefields 4 times so far. We received more equipment and more men today. The equipment went straight inside the tomb. As usual, I have no idea what it contained. We're expecting more Sith to arrive any day. Want us to capture one of the beasts for them. No explanation. It never is. Signing off. Coded messages from orbit and from Onderon. Some sort of conflict is going on. I think we have a ship in orbit. We're on full battle alert against what they won't say. The Sith must have said something about a disturbance in the Force. Well, what does that even mean? How do I prepare for that? The prophet's tone, the threat is serious. We've put a double shift on monitoring the aerial sensor grid. The only thing that could worry our master so much has to be a dropship invasion from the Onderon military. We will be prepared. The Sith said soon we'll have reinforcements. When I asked for details, he said it was a surprise. I hate the ones with the sense of humor. Sith jokes are rarely pleasant. Signing off. No!
I sense we are getting farther from our destination. Life is yours.
Thank you.
I had to run to catch up with you. You've made impressive progress. The Sith's camp lies in ruins. I told Kelborn of your progress. The rest of your squad is already en route to Isis. Also, Kex checked our sources for any information about this place. Kex believes that this is the tomb of Frida Nad. We knew it was somewhere on this moon. We had no idea how close it was to our camp. Some sort of fallen Jedi. He conquered Onderon long ago and became their king. The royal line is directly descended from him. That part of Onderon history the citizens try to leave buried and forgotten. Our priority here wasn't exploration. The mission was salvage in force, and to do so covertly, we have successfully pursued those objectives. Zuka didn't have our long-range sensors operational either. If this camp hadn't been sending messages, we may never have found it. Frida Nad was a dark Jedi. The stories say he was far worse than Revan and Malak ever were. This place is tainted, and the Sith presence here makes the danger great.
I can taste the power of the dark side here. Frida Nad must have been truly great to leave such an impact. The echoes of his life are still here. I feel secrets can be learned here.
I am returning outside. My attention is required to keep the path to our camp clear.
The time for practice is over. There are intruders in the tomb and they cannot be allowed to reach our master. The ritual must not be interrupted. I don't need to mention the price of failure. Men, follow me.
Let me handle this. The architect was that made that door, he or she was quite competent. Mandalorian iron, reinforced joints. Whatever is behind it isn't meant to be disturbed. Frida Nad's resting place must be beyond it.
Just one more moment. We're almost through. Failure, Captain, will not be tolerated.
As you command, my lord.
The ritual now. You're too late. We have done what needed to be done. Soon, Onderon shall fall, and with it, the Republic shall die. But what is this? Of course, the Force has guided you here. It echoes within you, yet I sense it is untrained. It is good you have sought us out. This tomb is strong with the dark side. Here is where you will take your first steps on the path to your destiny. An adept has managed to come so far. Incredible. You have within you the potential to wield the Force. I'm not speaking of the ways of the Jedi or their flawed teachings. Their order was rooted in weakness. They would have you become a puppet of the Force. They would have you deny the strength of your emotions, the strength of your own will. Can't you feel the power of this place? It echoes through you like a second voice. Accept it. Embrace it. So you seek to save me? From what? With the dark side, there is no knowledge forbidden, no restraints. What can you possibly offer me? Can't you feel the power? Here, within the walls of this tomb. Just embrace it. Don't limit your potential. A shame. Instead of freedom and power, you have chosen death. So be it.
Yeah?
What's wrong?